In November 1998, one cold night, an American builder had an experience that would mark his life in a radical way. With an excellent reputation in the city, a successful businessman in the construction field, he didn't imagine that night he would visit hell. He relates that he got up around 3 in the morning to have a glass of water, and before entering the kitchen, caught by an unseen force, found himself descending a tunnel toward the bowels of the earth. He thought he had died, a heart attack maybe. He kept descending at high speed and the temperature rising. After a few moments, he landed on a rocky ground, and due to the red burst of light that filtered through a window, he realized that he was like in a cell with a door, bars on the window, and that the heat was unbearable, impossible to sustain life, impossible. The temperature was such that he could barely get up. He crawled around looking for a way out, but to his greatest terror, he realized that inside the dungeon, some strange creatures were moving near his position. With the streaks of light that, as from an outside fire, dimly illuminated the cell, he could distinguish 3 figures, very tall, more than 3 meters each. They were not human, they were deformed, with a reptilian aspect, with claws and large jaws. He was literally locked in a cell with huge demons. This was insane. Those beings were launching terrible blasphemies against God, releasing hatred that could be felt. He tried to run, but impossible. His vital force left because of the intense heat. The beasts pounced on him as if he were a doll. With their claws, they tore his body apart, and they threw him against the hard rock of the wall. Billy was in shock. Could this be real? Life on the surface of the earth now was so far away. After minutes of torture, endless moments that seemed like an eternity, with the damage caused, it was more than enough to have bled. But he didn't die. It was as if his body reached the extreme of torture, but incapable of having death as an escape door, he couldn't die, even though at that time he wanted it. It seems that these beings stopped their torture for a while, and Billy, crawling on the floor, managed to live through the ajar door of the cell. And then he saw a terrifying scene that concentrated the horror of a thousand nightmares together. A deafening noise of thousands of people screaming in pain and agony. It was like a huge pit burning like a volcano, where thousands of people struggled, twisted by the pain of the flames. How to describe such a horror? What goes beyond our understanding, at the very limit of madness? Yes, in front of him he could distinguish thousands of people burning alive, the naked bodies twisting with intense pain, with the torch of suffocation, thirst, hunger. Some of these people tried to get close to the brim of the pit to escape from that furnace, but demons lined up on the edge pushed them back into the flames. Billy understood that if his position was regrettable, those in the fire pool suffered worse torture. He also noticed that the ground was infested with worms and nasty creatures. Billy also saw rats, huge snakes, and the repulsive stench of sewer, sulfur, and rotting flesh. But the saddest thing was the hopelessness of those lost souls, disfigured by fire, even ignored by the people of the world, friends and family totally unaware of this underworld, in which, unfortunately, many of them would also be caught in the future. Shortly after, Billy saw a light that seemed surrounded him, then a silhouette that he recognized as Jesus. Billy told him why he had sent him to hell. Jesus replied that to give testimony to the world, because many people think that hell is a myth. Even good Christians don't believe that hell is real. That God, as he loves everyone, cannot create a place like this. But let's not forget that God is also a judge. Her wife, asleep in bed, heard some screams and came out of the bedroom in his rescue. She found him at the kitchen door in a fetal position, screaming, "The Lord sent me to hell! The Lord sent me to hell!" He didn't tell anyone about this experience for months, for fear that they would take him for a madman, but he saw the need to warn as many people as possible. He agreed with his wife to leave the company job and began to give talks at churches and universities, and to anyone interested in this amazing story. He felt the pressing need to alert the world. It would have been an irresponsibility to withhold this information that must be revealed to every person. His testimony has touched many people. Many of them, moved by the story, changed the inertia of their lives through a more responsible action and in line with what God expects of us. We can see that all this is one more story, that everything ends in the grave. But one thing he made it clear as a summary of this story. Billy said on a television network that if people, skeptics, or even believers, would see hell for just 5 seconds, 5 seconds, they would certainly change. And he concluded, hell has to be avoided at all costs. Let's be smart, friends. What is at stake passes all understanding. Blessings.